Hi everyone, welcome you all. This is Pawan. In my previous video, I have given some tips to shift career from IT to non-IT, and especially people who are having some career gap. So I have got some comments on that particular video, and some people are asking about the certifications and about dummy projects and freelancing projects and so on. So I have consolidated those questions and I'm going to address those questions, especially in this particular video. So in the last video, I mainly focused on three things. One is certification, and the second one is dummy projects, and the third one is a freelancing experience. So these are the main things I have focused. Now, let me just elaborate what exactly they are and how we have focused on those three things, okay? So first of all, what are the recommended certifications in testing? So this is a question many of you asked in the comment section. So let me try to answer this one. So what are the recommended certifications in testing? So basically, certifications are preferable in three different scenarios, okay? And first of all, you need to remember, certification will not reflect your skill set, okay? Will not reflect your knowledge. That's the first thing you have to remember. Because your knowledge, your practical exposure only can get the job, not your certification. But I have recommended certification in three different scenarios. So the first scenario is, for example, you have a long gap in your career. You have a long gap. So to justify that particular gap during the interview, to justify that particular gap, if you have some certifications you have done, suppose, and you can easily justify it. Suppose one some certification I have done during my gap. So like that, you can justify your career gap if you have some certifications. So that's the one scenario. So second thing is, suppose you have a long gap, and more than 3 years, 4 years, or 5 years, it is very difficult to shortlist your resume because there are so many people coming from the colleges. Every year, lakhs of people are coming out. So there is a lot of competition in the market. So it is very difficult to shortlist your resume, right? If you have a long gap. So if you add some certifications, right? So it will help you to shortlist your resume. So that's the main purpose of adding the certifications to your resume, and your resume looks a little stronger if you had a certification to your resume. So that's the second scenario. And the third thing is, suppose if you are already working on something, or if you are already working on some manual testing project or some other project in another company, so your company management will recommend you to do some kind of certification, so that will help you to grow in your career. Because if you want to grow further positions, so you need some kind of a skills. So to grab those skills, management will ask you to do some kind of certifications. So in that case, those certifications will be useful for you if you're already in the career. Okay. So these are the three scenarios where I recommend certifications, but that certification will not reflect your skill set, or which will not reflect your knowledge during the interview. But at the time of interview, your knowledge, your practical exposure only will get you the job. Okay, please remember that. Okay, so but if you still want to do some kind of certifications, again, software testing and automation, if you just look at these two, software testing certifications are available in the market. And those certificates, some of the certifications are globally recognizable, and authorized certifications, you can do it. Like IS2QB and CSDT, there are some certifications are there. And if you do those certifications, they are globally recognized certificates. But whatever certificates they are issuing by the institute or any other organizations or any other consultant research, they are not valid at all. Okay, remember this. Unnecessarily, do not waste your time and do not waste your money on the certifications. Only few kind of certifications are globally recognized, especially software testing point of view. And if you do those certifications, that will be helpful to shortlist your resume. And at the same time, suppose if you want to justify your gap, your certifications will be useful. And if you want to grow in your career, and that time also certifications will be useful. So here I recommend two organizations. One is ISTQB, the other one is softwarecertification.org. So if you just go to these two organizations, they are offering various types of certifications. So let me just go through what are those certifications. So this is the basic software testing certification. Many of you aware of this, but this organization is offering so many certificates. So certified tester foundation level, this is the basic ISTQB certification, and this core advanced, this is the next level, like test analyst, test manager, technical test analyst, and AI testing, artificial intelligence, performance testing, test automation engineer, Agile tester, right? So Agile related certifications. And these are expert level certifications and expert level test management related certifications. So there are many certifications they are offering, and this is the organization globally recognized and authorized certifications. So if you want to do any certification software testing, you can just refer this website and what kind of certifications they are offering and how we can prepare for those certifications and how we can apply an examination, all those details they have already kept in their website. And this is the first thing I can recommend. So next thing is software certification. So if you compare these two, again, software certifications.org, a little bit costly certifications, and you need to pay more amount when you compare with the IS2QB. So now when you go to this particular website, softwarecertifications.org, and these people are also offering so many certifications, and this is also globally recognized. So we just go to the certification session. There are so many types of certifications basically they are offering. And also go to their homepage, and you can find all kinds of certifications, whatever they are offering. Okay, so these are the certifications basically they are offering. Software testing related, CAST, CST, CMST. Many people will do this kind of certification, or certified software tester. And then CSS, quality management related certificates. Okay, so there are many certificates they are offering, and these are certificates also globally recognized, but these certifications are a little bit costly. Okay, suppose if your organization or if your company is funding, so then you can do these kind of certifications. But if you want to do the certification you are alone, but it is a little bit costlier than IS2QB certifications. Okay, but as a beginner initially, if you still not started your career in testing, so you can just prefer to go with IS2QB. Okay, and people are already working on organization or in company, if your company is funding something, then you can go with these kind of certifications, softwarecertification.org. So these are the globally recognized software testing certifications are offering. So if you want to do any certification or software testing, you can choose one of the certification from these two organizations. Okay, but some institutes or some consultants or some organizations are also providing some kind of certifications after you complete the course, but they are not globally recognizable and they are not authorized certifications and they are totally invalid certifications. Okay, don't go for those type of certifications and unnecessarily do not waste your time and money for them. So this is all about certification related. So basically I have not recommend any certification, only specific scenario certification will be helpful. As I told before, the first scenario is what? If you have a long gap in your career, so to justify that gap, certification will be helpful. Second thing is to shortlist your resume, certification will be useful. Third thing, if you're already there in the career and if you want to grow to the next level, your management itself will recommend you to do some kind of certification. So that time you could do some kind of certifications to grow in your career. So that is all about the question number one. So next thing is where I can find dummy projects. So this is a common question many people were asked. So where I can find dummy projects. So first of all, we need to understand what is dummy project. So here automation point of view, I'm talking about automation prospective, whatever application you're finding through internet, everything is a real application. Everything is a live application, because in automation prospective, what exactly we need? We need a browser, right? We need an application. And from where we are getting those applications? Through internet. So whatever applications we are getting through internet, all are production applications. So we are not installing any applications, right? We are not setting up those projects. So whatever the projects, whatever web applications we are getting through internet, all of them are running through production only, on production environment only, right? So the dummy project in the sense what? Automation prospective, there is no dummy project or live project or real project. All projects are comes under same. Okay. The ultimately what you need is you need to have some website to practice. That's the most important. So automate something. You need to automate some test cases. For that, you need a website. And that application should have some kind of a features or functionality. So it can be any kind of application you can take through internet. There are so many demo websites are available. And even though they are demo website, they are providing so many features and functionality in their applications, and you can automate them. So that will give you real exposure. So don't think there will be dummy projects are separate, live projects are separate, real projects are separate. No, all of them comes under one category. But automation point of view, if I look at from automation point of view, all projects are same. basically they are running on production servers. So through internet, whatever applications you are able to access, whatever applications you are trying to automate, all are comes under projects only. All are comes under real projects only. Okay, but we are just calling them as a dummy projects or demo projects, something like that. But they are production applications basically. So there are so many applications are there in the market. So previously I have also done one video on this, especially web automation testing website and API automation practicing website. I have done two different videos on them. And I will share those link in the description. If you are not watching earlier, you can just watch those videos. So you can just see these are the two videos I have done. So demo websites and projects for practicing automation, demo website for practicing the REST API testing. So for API testing and especially web testing, for these two kinds of testing, I have consolidated some of the popular websites through internet, and I have provided those links also in the description when I creating these two videos. So please go through. So don't think like dummy projects are a kind of a useless projects, because whatever applications we are accessing through internet, all are valid applications. They are running on production servers. Okay, so you can take any one application and identify all the test scenarios and try to automate them. So design the framework from the scratch and identify some of the test cases for automation and try to do each and every test case automation. So that will give you real exposure, real experience to you. So that's how we need to practice on the dummy projects. But don't think live projects are different, dummy projects are different. So automation point of view, we need a website, that's it. So you can take any e-commerce site, or you can take any other flight traveling sites or flight reservation sites, like HR websites also available. So I will provide all the links in the description. You can find them and utilize those websites for practicing. So once you do at least one or two dummy projects or one or two projects, if you practice, so then you can get the freelancing projects. So again, people have asked how to get freelancing projects. So freelancing projects basically offered by many companies, and there are so many websites also available. But if you have a real exposure, good practical knowledge, you can apply for freelancing projects. And for that also I have done some video earlier. So here tips for how to get freelancing projects in software testing. So here I have listed out top 10 freelancing websites. And if you have a good exposure, practical knowledge, and you have done one or two dummy projects also at least, and you will be able to get the freelancing projects. And you can showcase your skill set and you can upload your resume in their freelancing websites. And if possible, whatever projects you have completed, you can maintain those projects in your GitHub repository, so that many of the HRs are nowadays looking into your GitHub repository, like what are the projects you have completed. So that will be very, very useful. And don't forget one thing, like in the resume also, specify your LinkedIn profile along with your GitHub repository URLs. Because nowadays, many of the people or interviewer or HR people are looking into those areas, especially your LinkedIn profile and also your GitHub repository. So whatever project, it can be dummy or anything, whatever you do something for practice, keep everything in the GitHub repository, so that will reflect to exactly you are practiced or not, you have done or not. So that is a proof for you. Okay, so maintain a Git repository. Every technical guy should have a GitHub repository, and you should maintain that, or you should mention that repository URL on your resume. Okay. And once you have a strong profile, and then you can apply for the freelancing jobs. So further, there are so many websites are there, top 10 websites I have consolidated and I have done this video. And I will provide this link also in the description. You can go through that video and you will understand that. So how to apply for freelancing job and how we can search for freelancing jobs, all that information I have explained clearly in this particular video. So that is all about how to get a freelancing project. So before that, you need to do some kind of a projects yourself. And once you practice it well, then you can apply for the freelancing project. So once you have done the freelancing projects, then you will gain the work experience. So then only you will gain the freelancing work experience. So especially many times for freelancing projects, they don't look at your academic study or any career gaps, all those things. Just you have proper skill set or not, that's the only thing they will consider many times. Okay, but if you go as a real company, or if you're going as an interview, or for a testing position or automation position, definitely they will look for everything. Your academic background or your career gap, all these things, your skill set, everything, they will look into it, and then only they will offer you. But freelancing job, it is very less importance will be given. So if you have a good skills, good knowledge, good exposure, practical knowledge, then definitely you will be able to get some freelancing projects. So there are so many people nowadays, they are doing freelancing projects. Okay, so if you do any freelancing projects, slowly you will get work experience. And that experience, you can use it for getting a job in the companies. Okay, so this is a recommended things. So how to find the dummy projects? Don't think everything is a dummy project. Whatever you can find through internet, all are real applications, live applications. They are running on the production servers. Take one or two websites and try to identify all the scenarios, all the test cases, and try to automate them. That will give you practical exposure. And then apply for the freelancing projects. And once you start doing the freelancing projects, then you will get the freelancing experience that you can project in your resume. Okay, so these things are recommended. So already done three different videos earlier, top 10 freelancing websites and how to demo websites for practicing REST API testing, demo websites for practicing automation testing. So these videos, links I will provide in the description. Along with them, I will also directly give these links, website for practicing automation almost for beginner level and intermediate advanced level. I have consolidated all the free applications. And you can, if you do this practice, if you do practice automation testing practice in these websites, that will give you practical knowledge. Okay. And then for API testing is also very important nowadays, because especially when you go for automation testing interview, people are expecting the API testing skills along with the web testing skills. So if you want to practice API testing, so these are the websites which are very well useful. And these websites especially providing the Swagger documents also. By seeing those documents, you can understand what are the APIs, what are the features of API, what is the input payload, output result, or like response request, what are the different type of requests, what are the different type of response. So you can do certain kind of validations while performing the API testing. So you can just practice all those things. I will provide you everything in the description and go through these videos once again if you have not watched till now, and they will help you a lot. Okay. So that's all for this video, guys. So next video, we will see a few more topics. So thanks for watching.